Phase and polarity are commonly mentioned topics in the audio industry, but they're rarely explained and often confused with each other. This video aims to clear up that confusion and explain both concepts. First, let's talk about what sound is. Sound is oscillations in air pressure that our ears can perceive and interpret. If I pluck a guitar string, it will move the air back and forth, creating positive and negative changes in air pressure. We can represent those changes as a waveform. Faster changes in pressure are higher frequency, and slower changes are lower. Bigger changes are louder, and smaller changes are quieter. That brings us to our first idea, polarity. Polarity is a concept that relates two identical waveforms to each other. If you take one sound and combine it with itself, it will get twice as loud, or 6 dB louder. But if you invert it so that all the positive peaks are negative and vice versa, the two sounds will cancel each other out. This is referred to as reversing the polarity, or sometimes inverting or reversing the phase. It's also referred to as being 180 degrees out of phase, but that's inaccurate, and we'll get to why in a minute. You'll find polarity reversal buttons in most DAWs and mixing consoles, and it can be a very useful tool. One use case is on a snare drum where you have a microphone above and below the head. When a drummer strikes the head, it will move closer to the bottom microphone, but farther away from the top microphone. This means the two microphones will have opposite polarity and will cancel each other out when combined. Reversing the polarity of one microphone will fix this so the microphone's sources will constructively add rather than destructively interfere. Alright, next let's talk phase. Phase is a way of describing a time relationship between two identical or similar signals. It's referred to in degrees, which to explain, I'll show you a circle, which has degree markings at 4 points. If you were to cut the bottom half of the circle and rotate it around, you would see a familiar shape, a sine wave. If I take a second, identical sine wave, but have it start when the first wave reaches the positive peak, we would say the second wave is 90 degrees out of phase. Again, it's important to understand that phase is a relationship between two signals. If we move the second signal 180 degrees out of phase, you'll notice that this has the same effect as reversing the polarity, which is why the two terms are sometimes interchanged. However, it's also important to understand that phase is frequency dependent. If I have a 500 Hz sine wave like we've been using, to put it 180 degrees out of phase would mean putting a 1 millisecond delay on the second signal. If we put that same delay on a 250 Hz tone, it would be 90 degrees out of phase with its counterpart. That's why it's important not to confuse phase and polarity, though people, including professional engineers with years of experience, often do so. Being 180 degrees out of phase is not the same as reversing the polarity, because phase is frequency dependent. That brings us to the more practical side of phase. Essentially, all audio signals in the real world aren't made up of a single frequency, they're made up of several together, whether that be noise or an individual tone and its overtones. If you have a phase relationship between two audio signals, different parts of the signal will be at different points in or out of phase. This means some frequencies will be adding together, but others will be destructively interfering. This creates what's known as comb filtering. When you get interference from a phase misalignment, the frequencies that cancel out will follow the harmonic series. This creates a cutout that looks like a comb in the audio waveform. This can make your audio sound hollow and artificial, so it's generally a good idea to avoid. You can get comb filtering anytime you have the same sound twice, with one source having a time delay. For example, when recording stereo sound with a non-coincident pair. You can check out my video on recording stereo sound for more on that. Any kind of multi-miking, as well as certain stereo mixing effects, can create comb filtering as well. In some cases, echo and reverberations of sound off a wall can also create comb filtering. Comb filtering isn't something that should always be avoided. For example, that type of interference helps us localize sound and can be used to create a convincing stereo image. Again, more on that on my upcoming mixing stereo sound video. Fortunately, fixing comb filtering when you don't want it is relatively easy. For two microphone sources, it can be as easy as zooming in with your DAW to look closely at the waveforms and adjusting them so they line up. There are also several tools out there which can automatically fix phase issues for you. Either way, it's important to have a strong understanding of polarity and phase, and why they aren't the same to be a good sound or audio engineer. Anyway, that's it for this video. I hope you like this video. If so, feel free to hit that like button. If not, feel free to hit the dislike button. If you have any questions or comments, feel free to leave those down in the comment section down below. And of course, if you want to see more videos like this, please hit that subscribe button.